Unit 6 dispatch.
Go ahead, Unit 6.
I'm on Polkin Johnson with the blue Subaru out with HPR 0612. Faulty brake lights.
Unit 6, be advised that vehicle's been reported stolen. Proceed with caution.
Yeah.
Oh, you're gonna be okay. It's just gonna take some time. It'll be all right.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to put that uniform back on again.
In time, you will. And if you decide that you want to do something else, I'm right behind you. Whatever you decide.
At least this time I didn't see his face.
Well, that's good. That's progress, right?
Yeah. I think so. You know, every time this happens, you know, gotta come running and save me. But I'm glad you do.
I'm here. I'm here for you. Yeah. I'm not gonna give up on you, Jack. It's okay. Let's go to bed. Okay?
Welcome to group, guys. We've got a special guest with us today.
It's Mr. Jack Rollins. Jack is gonna sit in with us, kind of see what we're about and see if he wants to become a little more permanent member of our group. I want everybody to give a good warm welcome to Jack.
Welcome, Jack.
Glad you're here.
Thank you.
Now, Jack, usually when we start these things off, I'm going to ask you to just give us a little background, tell us who you are, a little bit about yourself.
I'm Jack, and I was in the military.
Really? What branch?
Army. I was a ranger.
Good ride.
You free service?
Thank
you.
Then I ended up getting married and moved back here, became a cop. I'm not currently a cop. I'm actually on a sabbatical after what happened. I want to be a cop again. I just don't think I'm ready to put the uniform back on just yet. this was my wife's idea to be here. But I mean, I'm not saying I don't want to be here. But I do. She thought it would help, and I figured it couldn't hurt. So here I am. I guess that's it.
Man, we're just glad that you're here. And we want you to know that every one of us, me included, we're here for a reason. We've all got demons, we've all got issues. And, you know, maybe by being here, this is gonna help lift that burden off of you enough that you can function, man. Hopefully in time, you know, you're gonna be here and you're gonna recognize us as not just a little therapy group, not just as some people sitting here running their mouths, but as family and friends and people that you can come to help lift that burden off of you. Now, usually at this time, I'm gonna ask, you know, maybe that you would share a little bit about why you're here. What brought you to us? Now, you can or you cannot. This is your decision.
I think I'm just gonna sit this one out. That's okay. Maybe next time.
Okay. Man, that's perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. This is about you being comfortable opening up to us. Larry, man, won't you kick this thing off?
I'm Larry, and military myself, Special Forces, Vietnam all the way to Grenada.
Thanks, man. Hey.
Hey, how did it go?
It's okay.
Just okay? I mean, are you going to go back next week?
Yeah, I'm giving it a shot.
Good.
Nice group of people there, so.
Well, I'm proud of you for going today.
Well, don't be proud of me just yet. I don't know if this is going to help or not.
Still, though, I mean, first steps. I'm just proud of you.
Thanks. That right there helps more than anything.
Well, there's more where that came from.
Let's get out of here.
Okay.
What time are you heading out tomorrow?
First thing in the morning. Already got all my gear loaded.
You excited?
You have no idea. I've been waiting a long time for this. I'm ready to go.
I bet you are.
You know, it's not my first rodeo. I'm not gonna try to do the whole trail.
How often you gotta check in with Christine?
I'll check in with her every day. I got me a satellite phone. There's no cell service up there, so. How'd your first day at group go?
Oh, jury's still out.
Well, hang in there, brother. Give it time. I was proud of you for giving it a chance in the first place. You know, it was really good seeing you laughing and cutting up tonight. You hadn't done that in a long time. It's good to have my brother back.
I'm trying.
It's all you can do.
Hey, babe.
Hey.
You ready to go?
If you are.
That means she's ready. We're gonna get out your hair.
Be careful out there.
I will, bro.
Don't take any chances.
Me?
Yeah.
No, no way.
See you later, man.
All right.
Bye. And bye-bye. Take plenty of pictures, too.
I'll do that.
Okay.
Just snap yourself naked.
It is definitely beautiful out here.
Yes, it is. Uh-oh, I recognize that look. It's gonna be okay. It's not like I'm going off to war.
I know the Lord's going to protect you, but I'm just gonna miss you.
Well, they say absence makes the heart grow fonder. Maybe you'll love me more by the time I get back.
I don't think that's possible because, you know, you're already a 10 on my fond scale.
I know. You know I really need this.
I know you do, but promise me that you're going to call me every night.
I promise I will.
Okay. Please be careful.
I always will. I love you. And I better get rolling.
Love you.
Drive careful and no texting while you drive.
Okay.
I love you.
Love you too.
This is gonna be a good one.
Hey, love.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, I'm just checking my messages. How's it going out there?
It's going good.
Did you cover a lot of ground today?
Yeah, I got about 10 miles in today. Man, I tell you, I feel every bit of it, too. Whew, my dogs are barking.
What was that?
I don't know. You heard that?
Yeah. Was it an owl or something?
I'm not sure what it was.
Are you there?
Yeah, I was just listening. I don't hear it now. I don't know what it was. Anyways, how was your day?
Same old, same old. I did get the house clean today.
Good, good. I guess I better get off of here, save this battery. I just wanted to call and check in and let you know everything went okay today.
I'll talk to you tomorrow night.
All right, good night.
Love you.
Christine?
What's the matter, Ronnie?
I don't know. It's probably nothing.
Tell me. What's going on?
I don't know. I'm hearing these weird noises out in the woods. And there's something walking around out there.
Do you think it's a person messing with you? Another hiker?
I don't know. Maybe. I haven't really seen any sign of anybody else up here. I took a selfie this morning, and there was something in the background.
What did you see?
I don't know what it was. I couldn't make it out, but it was big. I thought maybe it was a bear, but it wasn't really shaped like a bear. And looked like it was watching me.
Maybe you ought to just cut the trip short and come home tomorrow.
Maybe. I'll decide in the morning.
If anything happens,
call me back and I'll call in the cavalry.
Okay, I will.
I love you, Aaron.
I love you too. I'll talk to you later. Bye. My name is Aaron Rollins. I'm making this video because I don't know what's going to happen to me tonight. There's something out there and it's getting closer. If anybody finds this video, tell my wife that I love her. I'm going to put this in my pocket and keep it running. And I'm going to go out there and I'm going to face whatever it is. Some kind of a joke. You better knock it off.
Jack. Christine called. It's about Aaron.
What happened?
He's missing. He hadn't checked in the last 2 days.
Oh, God. I was afraid something like this might happen. Come on, let's get over there. Let's not jump to any conclusions here. I'm sure the sat phone battery probably died.
Guys, I'm sure he's okay. I mean, maybe he just dropped it or it broke.
I'm sure there's a logical explanation for all this. Aaron's a big boy. He knows how to take care of himself.
But what if he's hurt, Jack? What if he can't get to the satellite phone? I'm going to call the sheriff in that county and I'm going to report him missing. It's been 48 hours. He'd have called me if he could.
Okay. Make the call.
Handgun man?
Yes. And he wouldn't have left his gun. Oh, my.
Oh, no. Did a black bear have done this?
Could be. They're pretty common in this area.
But where's Aaron? Where's my husband?
We're going to continue the search.
I don't see any bear tracks.
Hey, Dwight. I just found this phone about 50 yards off the trail.
That's Aaron's phone.
We may need it back, but you take it, ma'am. Let's concentrate our search up here to the north.
And there's a video on here.
Wait, what?
I have a gun. If this is some kind of a joke, you better knock it off.
Are those gunshots? What's he shooting at?
It's too dark.
I can't tell either.
Gone.
We're gonna continue the search. He could still be alive, man.
No, he's gone. It's gone. Okay,
take it easy, man. Gotcha. Get it up. Get up. We got you. Hey, just get back to the car, okay?
It's gone.
Okay, we'll send somebody
right out there.
Thanks.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Rollins.
Here to get my brother's stuff.
All right, I've got that over here. Let me get it for you. We've got everything in there, including this pistol. It's unloaded, of course, except for that. Tent. The condition it was in, I really didn't think you'd be wanting it back.
It's okay. I don't need it.
Y'all about to head home to Texas?
The wives are, but I want to hang around a little bit longer and search a bit more.
Oh, you are. Mr. Rollins, I hope you understand. You know, that's such a huge area of wilderness out there. It's about like being lost at sea. You're highly unlikely to find anything.
Yeah, I know, but it's my brother. Gotta try.
Well, understood. I guess if it was my brother, I'd be doing the same thing. How long do you think you're going to take?
A couple days at the most.
All right, well, you know that satellite phone was destroyed. There is no cell phone coverage up there at all. Could you stop back by here and let us know everything's all right before you head out?
I can do that. Thank you, Sheriff. I appreciate it.
Good luck to you.
Yes, sir.
Black bear attack is very uncommon in this area, but when it does occur, it's highly unlikely that there'd be any survivors. Our hearts and prayers do go out to the Rollins family at this time.
But the body of Aaron Rollins is still missing.
Well, I do realize that finding a body is something that's very important for closure for the family, but this is such a vast area of wilderness. Our manpower and resources are short, and we've already expended everything.
How's Christine holding up?
Not too good. I finally got her to lay down. She's sleeping.
Did you get the phone?
Okay. I'm gonna go shower.
I appreciate you doing this, Jack. But you know you don't have to.
I think I do. You'll do it for me. I love you. It's gonna be okay.
Don't take any risks out there.
I won't.
Okay.
Be careful driving back home.
I will.
I love you.
I love you.
far enough. Identify yourself.
I trapped these woods. I'm unarmed.
What are you doing out here at night?
Checking my traps. I smell the smoke. When I see who it was, I thought you might have been my cousin.
Jack Rollins.
Don Big Horse.
Why don't you come over by the fire and visit a bit?
Sure.
Not on the trip bar. Go ahead and take a seat. Warm yourself by the fire.
Thank you. I haven't seen you here before.
From East Texas.
You're still camping.
I wish I was. My brother went missing a few days back.
I saw that in the news, but they said it was a bear attack.
Yeah, that's what they said. It probably was a bear, but where's the body? We didn't find anything. I think we would have found something. I know this may sound crazy, but my brother called his wife the night before he went missing. He was afraid. Real afraid. It's like he said something was following him or stalking him out in these woods. I don't know.
Not crazy at all. I don't mean to sound discouraging, but I believe in honesty. You're not going to find your brother alive anyway. The protector of these woods is angry and howls for blood. And I think your brother was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Protector of the woods, I don't follow.
He has many names, but you probably know it best by the term Bigfoot.
You believe in Bigfoot?
Not a matter of belief for me. They live all over in certain areas. Also live in these woods. I grew up in these woods, and I've seen it twice now. Once as a teenager, and once only a week ago.
I'm not saying I don't believe you, Don. I don't know you, but it's hard for me to chalk up my brother's disappearance to some legendary creature.
I understand, and I'm not here to convince you. But I will tell you what I know, Mr. Rollins. Whether you listen, it's up to you. Last week, I was fishing in a river, not far from here, when I heard the gunshot. Not long after, I saw a wounded Sasquatch crawl out and die on the bank. Not even a minute passed before a second Bigfoot came out. It mourned. Then it became angry. I will pack up and go back to your family while you still can, lest you suffer the same fate as your brother.
But my brother wasn't here then. So even if these things do exist, it wasn't him that shot it.
It doesn't matter who shot it. Like I said, your brother was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
What about you being out here at night alone? Aren't you afraid?
I am afraid of them. But they know I pose no threat. I carry no firearm, only my knife. But you are a new face with a gun on his turf. They are very smart. It knows who comes in here with a weapon, the same kind of weapon that took the life of one of his own. You are out of your element. We visit the woods together. but he is the master woodsman, a master of camouflage and surveillance. He could be standing right by you, and you would never know it, unless it wanted you to know.
Yeah, I think I seen that post on social media too. What was it? Hide and seek champion of the world, right?
Funny. I saw that too. But there's some truth in every yoke. Well, I have to get going. If you insist on staying, may the Great Spirit protect you.
I believe I have that covered. Well, it was nice to meet you, Don.
Likewise. And I'm sorry about your brother.
Thank you.
Be safe.
Same to you.
Sorry, I forgot.
No worries. Are you okay?
Yeah. Goodbye.
Good night.
Where's the bell? Oh, somebody's just messing with you. No such thing as Bigfoot. No such thing.
Nobody's gonna believe you, Jack. Can't tell nobody about this. Just make it through the night. Out of here in the morning. Just being paranoid, Jack.
Thank you.
My God.
Thank you.
Get back in your... Hey!
Shots fired. Officer down at the corner of Anderson and Polk. Send back.
Hey, buddy, are you all right?
I don't know.
What are you doing out here?
I'm really not sure. I don't even know how I got here.
Hey, well, by golly, you don't look too good, so maybe you better get in and I'll take you into the hospital or something.
Yeah, if you don't mind, I'd appreciate it.
No, not at all. Hey, I'm just here to help you.
Thank you.
Mr. Rollins? How are you, sir?
Okay, I guess.
Do you know where you are?
Hospital?
That's right, you are in a hospital. Do you know what day it is, sir?
No.
I'm gonna go ahead and check your eyes.
Okay.
Aaron.
Christine.
Oh, we thought you were dead. What happened out there?
I really don't know. Everything seems so foggy.
Aaron has sustained a head injury. He has temporary amnesia. The majority of his memory will return, but not all of it.
How long do you think you'll be here?
I'd like to keep him here another day, just to monitor him to be sure. If you need anything, let me know, and I will be checking in.
Yeah, thank you, Doctor. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Rachel.
Hey.
Where's Jack?
He's still out there looking for you.
Looking for me?
Yeah. Yeah, we can't seem to get a hold of him, but they're gonna find him.
How long has he been out there?
He's been out there 3 days. But he just wouldn't give up on you. When everybody else did, he couldn't.
That's my brother.
Yeah.
Jack.
Sir, I'm glad to see you.
Oh, I'm glad to see you too. We've been looking for you.
Oh man, we better get you to the hospital.
All right, just take it easy. Just put your weight on me. It'll be all right. Just ease you into the back seat here.
All right, here we go. What the heck is that thing? What is that? What are you doing?
It's okay. It saved me. It saved me. Come on. Get to the hospital. It's all right. It's all right.
Sasquatch? Must have been. That thing was huge. Nobody's gonna believe this. Hey, I've got some good news for you. Your brother's alive.
Come again?
Yeah, we found him off Highway 15 this morning. He's in the hospital in Hot Springs. Your family sent me out here to find him.
Oh, that's real good news. That's real good news.
Welcome back.
Hey.
Like you had a rough one out there.
Oh, you're telling me. I gotta tell you about it sometime, but you may think I'm crazy.
I already know you're crazy, but it's okay.
How's Aaron?
He's doing good.
Good. Speak of the devil. Hmm.
And he appears.
He kept asking if you were out of surgery like every 5 minutes. He had to see you.
Oh, heard you come looking for me out there.
That I did.
Looked like you had a little worse than me.
Boy, have I got a story to tell you guys. When I'm up to it though.
Yeah, my memory's starting to come back. There's a few things I want to talk to you about too.
That sounds good. Promise me one thing, though, brother. Next time you go missing someplace tropical. I think I'd enjoy looking for you a lot more there.
I bet you would. Seriously, thanks for coming to look for me, brother.
Hey, that's what brothers are for, right?
Right on. Even if you couldn't find me out there.
Get out of here.
You two are always joking around.
Always. You know, for the longest time, I didn't pray to God. And I know a lot of you don't believe in God, and that's okay. But for me, God's a big part of my life before the accident. And it's not like I blamed God or was mad at him or anything like that. I just withdrew. Became this recluse. Man, this is hard.
Take your time, Jack. Just take your time. It's gonna be okay. We'll get through this.
I guess what I'm trying to say is, and I'm not trying to preach here, okay? I'm not trying to become this preacher. But the Bible says our life on this earth is like a vapor. It's here 1 minute, gone the next. And this baby boy is with him in eternity. With him now, nobody, nothing can pluck him out of his hand. He'll never have to suffer again. And I know that one day I'll see that boy again. I'll see him again. And I'm ready to be a cop again. I'm ready to put this behind me and move on with my life. I just think it took someone special to show me that life is still worth living. Thank you all for your support.
You're brilliant.
Shit.
Jack, man, that's amazing. I know I speak for all of us when I tell you how much we love you and how proud of you that we are.
Keep it.